Impact of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday with you two, even better than the real thing, and with or without you. It's Opie and Anthony, and no, we did not get fired.
No, we're back. We're back.
We're back.
I'm reading these emails, some people concerned, Opie, that for our hijinks on Friday, that we may have been terminated here to NEW, but no.
No.
We are indeed here. We just took the day yesterday.
Yeah, that's what we're telling people.
Thanks for Tony Pegg for sitting in on our show on Monday.
And thanks for management understanding our concerns. Okay.
Well, at least... if you missed Friday's show, you could pop up the pictures on the website and, oh, that's right, they're not there anymore. that's interesting.
I wonder if the two events are related.
Let's see.
People are making, they're starting their own conspiracy theories. The website was gone and we were gone from the radio yesterday.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Let's pop up, because a little page comes up when you, you go to our website to see the pictures of maybe a black girl being whipped by the dominatrix.
Right.
Or you want to see the Mentos video, which was just so popular. People love that.
Mm-hmm.
Or the pictures of Tara, again, if you had missed them.
Yeah.
The blonde chick. Let's look. Oh, the website you're seeking cannot be found. Possible reasons. Well, let's run through these and see maybe one fits.
Okay.
You may have mistyped the URL. They are complicated. Sometimes you can mistype them, but I was using a favorite link, so it wasn't that I typed the name in.
And you just click on the icon, so I don't think people...
Yeah. The site could be under construction. Please try back later.
No, I don't
think that fits.
Considering if you saw the website before we got kicked off, there was not much construction ever going on.
Right.
There.
See, the account may have been moved or no longer exists.
No, it's still there. Trust me.
Mm-hmm.
I know where I put the stuff.
The site may have been removed due to violating our accepted uses and policy standards.
Well,
now that might be it. Let's click on that link and see what their policy is.
Okay.
All right. Unlawful activities such as unauthorized distribution or copying of copyrighted photos. No.
No.
We took those. Copyrighted software? No.
No.
Export restrictions?
No.
Fraud?
No.
Solicitation of gambling or prostitution?
Not really.
Not that I know of.
Okay.
Practices which may be considered obscene and/or illegal material.
Whoops!
Hey! There it is! Winner! I knew it was in there. Well, WebJump. The people at WebJump have deemed our material obscene, Opie.
The fine people of WebJump.
Something the Supreme Court of our United States of America cannot even define obscenity, but they have seen it as obscene.
They have decided our stuff is obscene, Anthony.
So now
we're looking for another provider at this point in time.
Why cannot I find a land for my material to rest in peace? My God, we traveled journey together on this internet just looking for a homeland that will accept us. Let my pornography stay. Damn you, WebJump. So here we are. Our journey continues for a homeland. Why, damn you, why can't I put my smut on a website? Damn you! I have a clip of that horse having sex with a girl, too. They won't let that on there either. Damn them all to hell! We will journey through the desert, trying to find a website that will accept us for what we are. Purpose! Damn you! Well, there we go. That's six or seven sites we've been kicked off of.
I believe that would be six.
And our own NEW site won't even let us on there.
No, they won't even acknowledge us at this point, our material.
All right. Well, the search continues for a server. I'm trying here, people.
Yeah. So it may be a few days. We'll find someone new.
We'll get something. Don't worry. They'll be back.
All right. Well, that's a nice little start to the
program.
Well,
there you go. We're off.
We got the boss in the studio, but if we put him on mic, we're going to have to ask him some hard questions, so we'll let him sit there.
Oh, yes.
Unless he wants to take a mic.
You were quoted in the Daily News today, boss. Did you see that? I like his answer.
That wasn't a quote.
His answer is, it wasn't a quote. It was him saying that...
We don't comment on rumors.
We don't comment on rumors.
Short, concise.
I like it. To the point. Did you have him whacked after he asked you such an insulting, disrespectful question?
We actually never talked.
You didn't?
No.
So how did he get that?
Well, he left me a message that he wanted to talk to me.
Yeah.
And I left him a voicemail message back saying there's no reason to talk to me, but if you want a quote to put in your column, my quote would be.
Oh, I see. Hey, this is all about this whole thing about NEW just flipping formats for some reason. Now it's a rumor that it's going to be a talk station. I don't know. I haven't heard anything, but I am disturbed by something I read in that Daily News thing, boss.
What's that?
Did you read it?
Yes.
NEW staffer, and all of a sudden they're spilling what was said in our private meetings? Did you read that? I want him dead!
We got
right. I want him whacked! How do you do this? How do you handle this? Luca Brasi?
You know what?
Who are you going to get? We got to whack this guy.
You round up the usual suspects and you question them.
Who is it? I think this person should be made an example. You know, like... All right, grab the cannolis.
And you know what? Not that the things we talk about are like ultra top secret, but what good could possibly come from talking to the newspapers about things that go on in our staff meetings?
Exactly.
Now, where do you think the rumors start? The rumors start from other radio stations.
Yes.
That are just trying to cause tumult.
Right, Godfather.
So who needs that?
You are right. You are right, Godfather. Don Herman. We are behind you all the way. And we will find this traitor who, in the paper, is letting out family secrets. I don't like this.
So how are you going to find them?
Oh, well. I think it's the person that is going to arrange security for our next meeting. Tessio. That bastard. He was always the smart one. It's strictly business. I understand this. But we can't let these people off the hook. I want him whacked.
See, usually, it's the person that comes to ask you about the format change that was the one that leaked it.
Oh, who came to you?
Oh, everyone.
All right. We will have to track this person down, though. And Don Herman, we will bring him to you. And you will administer your justice as you do with your baseball bat up in your office. I want his head cracked open. We cannot have our family business spilled about the papers in this fashion. Thank you.
So are we going all talk?
Is that the whole
Opie, don't go to him with the quest. Oh my God. We're going to have to. It's going to be like Fredo.
Is that the rumor?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do we have your permission to turn our show into a talk show? That'd be fun.
Well, what do you think we're doing?
This is pretty much. How much, whether they like it or not, Opie, we've already made that decision.
You've been on the air 23 minutes. How much music have you played?
The Godfather theme.
Well, today we played four records already.
Sounds like it doesn't matter what I think. It sounds like you've already made it a talk station.
Maybe that's where the rumors started.
Yeah, really. They're listening to the Opie and Anthony show going, I never hear music.
I think the rumors started with Steve Mason and you guys.
You think so? Oh, we're conjuring this up.
No.
Interesting.
Oh, we got website providers on the line, Ant.
Oh, good. Get them. Tell them I don't want to sign anything. I don't want this wacky. If you use 100 gigs, we pay, then you pay. I want a password. I want a username, and I want megs of storage space, unlimited bandwidth. It sounds like a lot, but trust me, I will pop a banner on your stupid site.
We'll take care of you.
I need space. I need speed. I need unlimited bandwidth.
All right,
I need prostitutes.
You want to take a break, I guess?
Oh, yeah. Are you going to play music or something?
Well, it is two for Tuesday.
Oh, that's right. We've talked twice as long as we usually do.
Why do you say it like that? See, that's what puts the rumor. That's what prolongs the rumor. Look,
he didn't sound enthusiastic.
He didn't sound enthusiastic.
Right.
Well, I'm enthusiastic because there's only a few of these left. So.
Oh! Check, please! Wow.
We can at least see the end, the light at the end of the tunnel, so.
Sound enthusiastic. The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday, Creed. That's one. My Own Prison before that from their debut CD. It's Opie, it's Anthony.
Hey.
Wow. And no, we did not get fired. We just took a day off yesterday.
Yes, we are back.
We are back. We got to talk to Earl.
Maybe not this break. Maybe later on in the show, because we haven't seen him since he got punished with all those nasty pictures.
When did the website actually throw the pictures off? Was it over the weekend or today?
If you're just tuning in, we have a lot of you know, pretty rude pictures under the semi-live studio cam of our section of the WNEW website.
Yeah.
And we just got thrown off our sixth server because of the content of our pictures.
Yeah, yeah.
That being pictures of Earl getting disciplined by Spike.
Yeah.
His hands were tied. He was gagged. There were things in his face that shouldn't be in his face.
Yeah, she had something, an apparatus, strapped on, let's just say.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, she had high heels on. She was gouging them into his groin area. Pretty sick.
Some of the best pictures I've ever seen.
Yeah, really good.
And I don't know. I checked yesterday afternoon, and they were gone.
They were gone yesterday afternoon?
Oh, yeah. They may have been gone by, like, Sunday or Saturday.
God. Man.
So
we're looking for a server now. We've gotten some leads, so hopefully I'll have these pictures back up by later today or tonight.
Well, we need a site by Friday because I think a couple girls are taking on Tara as the hottest girl to ever be naked on the Opie and Anthony show.
Friday?
We need some web space by Friday.
Yeah.
Hi, NEW.
Hello.
Hi, what's going on?
Hey, what's up? I heard you guys need a new web provider.
Yeah, but this is boring for the radio, so hold on.
Yeah.
All right.
Just get his name and number, man. Hi, NEW.
Yellow.
Hi, NEW.
Yeah, they were still there at 5:30 last night.
Oh, they were?
Yes, they were.
That's about when I checked, so.
They were still there. They were there Saturday night.
Okay.
They were there Friday night.
All right.
Because I checked Friday. I heard it from upstate New York, the broadcast, and I checked it Friday night.
Oh, so they threw it off
last night or sometime. From last night to this morning.
That's okay. That means we got three good days out of it.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting much more than that,
they
to tell you the
good.
Truth. I think between
very,
the...
very explicit.
I think between the Earl getting disciplined and then the Mentos video, I think really put it over the top. That was a little explicit.
It took a long time to download.
Yeah, it was a big file.
Yeah, we got to get a faster server too.
Yeah, fast server, that should just pop right up.
Is it the host or is it the receiver when they try to download it?
I think it's the host, if I had to guess.
Yeah. Yeah. It wasn't really.
I'm not great on that kind of stuff, but. It took a while. I did other things around the house while that thing came out.
Oh, no. See, that should never be the case.
Nah.
I mean, there are servers out there. If you clicked on that Mentos file, it should have taken, what, a minute tops?
No, I think it took over 10, 15 minutes.
Really?
For me, yeah.
We need a faster provider
than that.
A couple
of minutes.
I honestly do think it took that long.
All right.
Because I was doing other things Friday night when it was there.
There you go. All right. Thanks, buddy.
No problem.
All right.
All right.
Hi, NEW.
Hi. I just wanted to say that, you know, those pictures weren't so great to begin with.
Really?
You know, Spike isn't that great looking.
Spike?
No,
you got to understand, she's hot in the dominatrix kind of way.
You know, okay, in that way.
We're not looking for a Playboy model. She was all about, like, discipline and chains and whips and tattoos and.
Yeah, but you know, you could have got somebody much better looking.
I don't know. As far as dominatrix go, I think we were right on top of it.
Spike works, man.
I mean,
maybe Tara doing the dominatrix thing might have worked.
But Tara's like the girl next door. That's what her look's all about. And Spike is all about, like, scars and scabs.
Spike's the real deal.
And being gnarly and stuff.
You know, her boobs weren't the same size. They were.
I noticed that. The one boob was a little bigger than the other.
Oh, yeah.
But, I didn't like that.
Oh, boy, but who cares?
Jeez. I guess Miss Perfect here wants to come in here and pose.
No.
Know what we could do?
What?
We could have a dominatrix beauty pageant.
Oh, that's an idea.
With a little talent portion?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Maybe.
I mean, calling all dominatrix. I mean, the publicity
maybe their boobs would be the same size.
I don't know. I would put my money on Spike on a dominatrix beauty contest.
What was with the blue eyeshadow?
That's what I mean. And she's all about, like, looking like...
The look.
Yeah, she's all, you know, scabbed up.
You're not in the scene, so you don't know what it's about. We're in the scene.
And maybe the top, you know, with the sock that Tara was wearing, maybe that would have helped Spike a little bit.
Mm. No, we're in it.
You're in it.
Yeah, we go down to the seedy clubs. Yeah.
Anybody could be in it.
All right, wait. What do you look for in a dominatrix? You're not going to get a really, like, hot Playboy model that pulls off the whole dominatrix angle.
No.
They could dress up in the dominatrix gear, but it's just not the same.
It works in Fredericks of Hollywood.
They're not going to be able to do it, though.
Yeah,
she cracks the whip.
You know?
She cracks the whip. She has strap-ons.
So you'll get a girl that's all hot, dressed up in this lingerie with a whip, going like, ooh, do you want me to tap you? No, you need the real deal. Spike's real.
I mean, there's a... there's a chance you're going to get hurt when you're with Spike.
Yeah.
All right.
It's not about, fake S&M. She's the real deal.
I'm sure there are people out there who are into this that are decent looking.
Let me tell you something.
No. No, actually, there aren't.
Let me tell you something about Spike. She gets like $200 an hour to do that. She's got like, on Friday night, she was with a pretty serious TV producer that's in his 60s that likes to dress up as a girl as Spike disciplines him.
She dressed him up in a little girl dress.
She's the real deal. It's not about let's get a little wild on a Friday night, honey.
I know.
This lady makes her living.
Well,
I find her attractive.
You do?
I do. There's something very attractive about her.
What is it?
I don't know what it is. There's just something about her.
First of all, her body is definitely not bad.
Yeah, I like her bod. And even if you get past that makeup and stuff.
Boob thing? I mean, guys.
I've seen a lot worse boobs.
And she's a dirty girl. She's a very dirty girl, and that's attractive.
Well, we can all fit the role sometimes.
You must be really hot because you're picky.
Come on.
Are you hot?
No.
Then why are you so picky?
I'm not picky. I'm just saying, if you're going to put pictures on the internet, let's have some
You can go to, Playboy.com and get that crap. We're showing the real deal.
The real deal.
The stuff that gets kicked off of 6 consecutive web servers.
Yeah, scabs.
We're proud of it.
Scabs and all. I mean, Spike had hickeys and bruises all over her body, man. She was all roughed up.
You could punch up pictures of hot girls on the web at the drop of a hat. Put in hot girls and everything will come up.
I don't know.
This offers something that's a little different. Stuff that gets banned.
I mean, it's your opinion. I respect that. But I could take an hour of calls from guys that all just would love to be with Spike for an hour.
You know what? You guys have a little twisted, I don't know. You're into not the not so pretty looking girls. Even the girl with the blonde hair that was on the pictures.
The little
she
spinner.
She was ugly too. Come on.
She wasn't ugly. She was like a little dirty girl.
What, the Gwen Stefani lookalike?
Yeah.
She's not ugly.
What was with the hairdo?
She wasn't ugly.
Come on.
I've seen the hotter girls, but I wouldn't take her out of bed, man.
I think you guys just have different, your tastes are not the norm.
I don't know. I also, like to look at a real hot model and stuff. It's all what you're into. It's all taste.
Okay. All right. Opie, you're kind of cute, too, All right, guys, I got to go.
Well, send a picture.
All right. I'll send a picture.
All right. Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Yeah, the blonde girl's hair kind of did have that Sally from, who's that, Sally Hansen?
Sally
from
Hansen.
Davy and Goliath.
Davey's, oh, my God.
Davy's sister. Davy Hansen's sister, Sally. Remember her hair?
Yeah.
Looked like the blonde thing, but two, yodels.
Yes, yes.
On the side. It was like those round. Even as a kid, I'm watching going, hey, damn it, that looked like a couple of yodels.
What do you think, man? Dominatrix beauty contest.
Yeah, I like it.
You line up the dominatrix.
And beauty is just a word and when we use it in that fashion.
All sizes and shapes.
Mm-hmm.
I know there's a lot of dominatrix women that listen to us. They come in with their little get-up, and we'll have the listeners vote who's the hottest dominatrix.
The hottest dominatrix.
Or someone, we'll crown the hardcore champion, as someone said on Friday.
Hardcore champion of the world! Yeah, we could do that.
That's Spike's title, officially.
Yeah, she's the hardcore champ.
In WWF terms, Tara is the champ, hottest girl to ever pose naked on the Opie and Anthony show, and Spike is the hardcore champion of the world.
We need our intercontinental and European champions. And the belts will just change hands every day.
All right. You want to play some more music?
No.
Well.
Yeah.
We got until they flip, so let's...
You're confirming rumors, Opie. This is not... These are rumors. The bosses are going to great lengths to say these are indeed just rumors.
That's
started by other stations, people in the business. NEW has not made any decisions as far as changing any formats. I don't know what you're saying.
Okay.
You heard the boss say he's not commenting on rumors.
Right. Well, we asked him, and he didn't give us an answer.
No, he didn't. I found that a little suspicious.
Look into it, man. We're not that dumb.
Hey, come on.
So, all right, we'll play a couple tunes. What the hell?
For a goof, huh?
For a goof.
We'll play a couple of tunes for a goof. I understand.
We'll play a tasty cut.
Yeah.
From Pink Floyd. We'll get, we'll get a Pink Floyd song out of the way that you've heard a million times, and then one you've only heard a couple. Is this the MDA telethon all of a sudden?
But it sounded like Close Encounters.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday. Pink Floyd from Metal. That's Fearless. And Run Like Hell before that. It's Opie and Anthony. Thanks for checking us out today. Appreciate it.
Yeah. All right.
Britney's, what's her name? Britney Spears?
Yeah.
Britney Spears on MTV right now.
Yeah. Let me look.
Oh, yeah. I liked her better when she was called Debbie Gibson. Same chick, right?
I think so. Yeah. I think you're right there.
Pretty much. Did anyone else see the... God darn it. I knew I forgot something today.
What?
We were goofing on Jesse from MTV.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you see the commercial they're running every, like, 2 minutes on MTV?
Yes, I have.
How if he could be a VJ, anyone can?
Yeah.
Damn, we need that audio.
That would be a VJ. Very cool. That I get a good concert. It's very cool being stupid retard.
Because they're running that contest again, looking for another VJ.
Yeah, this time I'm convinced they're just going to get a rock. Just get a big dopey rock, put it somewhere, and put like VJ Rock underneath it.
Yeah.
And then they'll just show it and then go to a video.
Yeah.
It would be less annoying than that stupid Jesse.
And then just put the VJ Rock on tour and people would come out to see the VJ Rock.
You are so right.
You know?
They could make the Rock famous. Mm-hmm. So that when people see a rock, it'll be like, well, that's not the Rock. That's not the Rock. But then when they bring the VJ Rock to your city, you'd like stand online.
Of course you would.
Dude, that's the Rock. Get a picture of me with the Rock. They should do that.
That's
better than to Jesse. Yeah, I'm a VJ.
We got to roll tape on MTV because they will run the spot.
Yeah, they've been playing it every 2 seconds.
Every
I
two
know.
Seconds.
But what was the question?
But that's how pathetic our society is as far as fame and stuff goes. If we put like a Rock on TV long enough and then you put the Rock at a bookstore, people would line up to get a picture with the Rock.
With the Rock. MTV rocks with the Rock on spring break. And like have the Rock with a bunch of chicks in bikinis.
Yeah.
And it's a whole special.
Exactly.
The Rock spring break special. And there's just no sound. It's just the Rock.
It's just the Rock to check
and
out.
And chicks. You'd watch.
Of course you would.
More than I would Jesse, because then I'd turn it off. Even with the chicks.
Hey, we have spin back. It's very cool. I got the intelligence of a 6-year-old. And we have spin back. Wow, this is so great. We're going to launch good bands.
Click, click, click. I cannot change the friggin' channel faster. I don't care if there's 20 naked chicks behind them.
Yeah.
I can't get past.
You think how much sperm you think it takes to get his hair like that?
Hey, you want to throw another batch of?
Oh, there's something about Mary in his head. I mean, come on. We gotta get the audio of Jesse. Someone roll tape on MTV. And then we'll put it on the air, and then we'll goof on it for another 20 minutes.
You could be a VJ, too.
Oh, you cut out his brain, you bastards.
All right, Anthony, stacker two.
Stacker two, you need a boost of energy?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
You all right, man?
Yeah, I'm on stacker two.
He has energy. Look at him go. Wow. Now, you've taken this.
I took it today.
And it gives you the energy you need to make it through the day.
Yeah, it's helping me.
It is.
Gives me a nice little boost of energy just in time for the show.
That's good.
And there you have it. It also says it burns fat, Anthony.
Mm-hmm. I guess if you're getting tired during the day, stacker two would be for you.
Yeah. If you're looking for an energy boost, you could try stacker two. If you're not happy, they'll give you your money back. The company's in New Jersey. You pop a pill within an hour, you get a boost of energy. And to order it, you could call 1-800-LIGHTLINE. The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday, Aerosmith. Dude looks like a lady and dream on. Those guys at the Oscars the other night, that is weird, huh?
Yeah.
It was very strange.
I think they're kind of fitting into that whole thing these days.
I don't know. Steven Tyler didn't look like he fit in with the Oscars.
I mean that way. I mean just with the age bracket of the people that are there, all that whole pomp and circumstance, hoity-toity, stuck-up people.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know, Op. I think he's fitting into that category these days.
Like a sellout?
And that damn soundtrack, man, to the Armageddon. I don't know.
N.E.W.
Hey, yo, you guys know that Aerosmith song they played on the Oscars was written about Barbra Streisand and James Brolin, man?
I don't want to miss a thing.
Yeah, that's actually James Brolin looking at Barbara Streisand sleeping, man.
I remember that whole thing.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Opie said that Aerosmith's a rock band. Man, they ain't no rock band anymore.
Not anymore.
Did you check out Joe Perry's hair?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It What's going on there? I mean, you know, I must say, I love Aerosmith, but...
Yeah,
he's got to do
something. The 70s, they were great.
He's got to do something with that hair.
Definitely.
I'm wondering how many guys have been hitting on him lately with that hairdo.
No doubt. Hey, you guys are great, man.
At least he chopped off that weird Fu Manchu thing he had going on.
Right.
That strange, I don't know what it was. It was like the Hitler mustache reversed.
Backwards.
Right.
Yeah, you shaved out the middle.
Out the middle and had the rest.
Hey, wait a minute. I want to know, is that really what that's about?
Yes.
Now, who wrote that?
You know, I don't know her name. It's not coming to me right now, but I saw it on like a Barbara.
Barbara
Waters. Walters.
Yeah, I remember this. James Brolin was saying James Streisand. Talk about the biggest pussy whip on the
right?
face of the earth.
What normal man looks at a freaking woman after he does her? He's asleep, man.
Well, no, he said that he looked at her one day.
Right.
And didn't want to go to sleep. He goes, I don't want to go to sleep. And Barbara goes, why don't you want to go to sleep?
And that's what the song's about.
And he said, because
I don't want to miss a thing.
Yeah, I'll miss you, and I don't want to miss looking at you while my eyes are closed. Jesus.
Oh.
Barbara Streisand you're bedding down with, not Pamela Lee.
I know, right? She's not even good to look at awake anyway.
You know, remember the young James Brolin? You just figured, you know, he was a cool guy back in the 70s even. What, Marcus Welby he was on?
Tough guy, right, man.
Tough guy.
You could get any chick he wanted.
And then he's there, Barbara, I don't want to shut my eyes because I'll miss you, sweetums. And that's what that song's about?
That's what that song's about.
Aw, make me puke.
Exactly. I can't listen to that song anymore. I want to punch the radio, man.
Well, what do you think of the Oscars?
I really don't watch that stuff, but I actually sat with my wife and watched it, and I don't know. I almost threw something at the TV, man. I can't take it. You know, we got into a big fight and stuff, and she went running upstairs.
Oscars.
Just switched on the sports channel, you know.
It's so not real and not anything any of us can relate to. These Hollywood bigwig jack-offs just parading around in their gowns and jewels. And
yeah, but that's what women love that, man.
Yeah, it's a whole fashion show and stuff.
Yeah.
I'm not sick of Roberto Benigni yet.
Oh, God, I can't take that guy anymore.
Come
as an Italian, I want him shot. I go, this is great, marvelous, this is wonderful. I cannot believe you, America. You love me. I love everybody. This is fabulous. I cannot shut up. Have you had enough of this guy?
You see that S... S eating grin. I almost slipped.
Right.
That he had during the whole Oscar.
Yeah, he's like an Italian retard walking around.
It looks like a retard that you just brought to the zoo and they just saw some animals.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
All happy and stuff.
Yeah,
right.
That's what he is.
You know.
Look at me.
I just made a poopy in my pants.
And hey,
and
everybody.
Would you like to see the poopy in my pants?
Everyone's like. The anchor doing the news comes back from the clips of the Oscars and like they're all laughing. What spirit this man has. Is he great? He's so up all the time. Who cares? This is wonderful. I cannot believe you American people love me. This is fabulous.
How about that Robin Williams character, though, man? Is anything he says funny at all anymore?
No.
It never was.
It's unbelievable, man.
It never was. We were all tricked.
Even Whoopi Goldberg. I mean, nothing she said was even close to funny.
Whoopi is not funny. I don't think she ever has been. And she proved that last night, too. Because, I mean, all she ever did was used like that her black slang thing and goofing on the president.
Right, And then the next minute she talks like a white person.
Yeah.
Like
a white person.
I'm serious.
Oh, my goodness.
She's talking Ebonics. The next minute she's talking like a white person.
Well, I know what you're trying to say.
But they got a little upset. A few of the executives at the station got upset because she was manipulating the microphone. At one point,
really?
Like it was a penis?
Yeah, when Liam Neeson was being introduced, he's stroking the microphone like it was a big schlong.
Like God. Liam's going to want a piece of you.
Yeah, like that's a vision we need to see.
Oh, gosh, she's got to wear baggy pants so her boobs can fit in her legs. Those things are swinging.
What's that old joke? What does Whoopi Goldberg giving you a Hummer and tightrope walking across the Grand Canyon have in common?
What?
What?
In both, you don't want to look down.
Right.
I love that guy.
All right,
there it is.
Listen, I gotta get
there it is. Are we rolling tape?
All right, man. Take it easy.
Love you.
Yeah, there it is. The Jesse commercial just came on. Good. We have tape of it.
We have tape of it. Get that on card immediately. We got a goof on Jesse, the spot they're running on MTV. So there you go. I don't know if there's anything else to talk about with the Oscars.
That was pretty lackluster, pretty boring. There wasn't any...
Would you throw Sophia Loren one still or what?
No, stop with Sophia Loren. Everybody's saying how what a babe she is. She's like a grandma. She's like a great-grandma.
I don't know, man. There was something going on.
I don't know. Dude, it's TV. They cake stuff on. They're pulling, tugging.
I don't know.
Yeah, you want to see that? Hey, Opie, come to me. Come over here. As she takes it off and just like a mess. You want to see that?
I don't know, man. I think I'd go on.
I love Sophia. She's a beautiful, isn't she? Everybody's wonderful.
Why not?
I don't know, man.
You wouldn't throw Sophia one?
You have a problem.
James!
Hi, Eddie Delphi.
You love the old broads, man.
All right, what do you got?
Sophia Loren's 80.
You know about the Al Sharpton quote the other day?
No, what's the Al Sharpton quote?
When he was talking about he's going to do a hunger strike at Rikers Island. Did you hear about that?
Really? No.
It was yesterday. They quoted him because of... the fact that if he's doing that march in Washington, D.C.,
right.
If that doesn't work, he's going to come back to New York, and he's going to do a hunger strike at Rikers Island.
But like a whale, he could live off that blubber for years.
Exactly.
A camel with its hump.
I don't think he can go an hour without a meal.
That'd be pretty damn funny to say.
I will continue this until we have justice. Now, how long's it been? Damn, my stomach's growling.
Right.
I'm a little... Now, does a hunger strike include yodels and ringdings? Just want to clear that up. What about a coffee cake? I love them drinks, coffee cake.
I need a value meal.
How about a happy meal?
Right. All right. I guess we'll take a break here.
We have the Jesse clip now.
Right?
You just got to hear how retarded that... weren't there talented people that actually wanted to be VJs?
Well, honestly, there's a lot of kids, let's say,
yeah.
that are in broadcasting, and they work their ass off 4 or 5 years in college, and they
yeah.
want to break in the business.
Mm-hmm.
And it's almost an embarrassment. You turn on the tube, you're working your ass off, and you see someone like Jesse on MTV.
Yeah.
You know?
I understand.
It's taking up space, and there's a lot of people that really want to do that and would do a great job.
It's like the original Mercury astronauts, Opie. Very qualified,
mm-hmm.
highly trained. And they were upset when they used to send the monkey up in the capsule.
Well.
It's the same thing. They got a monkey running the show.
Pretty much.
Jesse, that's great.
You want to hear Petty or the Pumpkins?
Oh, God, that's nice pumpkin. That's a good bear.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday, Smashing Pumpkins, Cherub Rock, and 1979.
Hey, what we didn't touch on with the Oscars just before was the whole Lewinsky thing.
Yeah.
Like, she went to all these parties.
Mm-hmm.
She got in her big fat gown.
Yeah.
And went with Jonathan Marshall. I guess he's some entertainment lawyer or something.
Yes,
in New York.
City here.
And made the rounds of the parties. That just goes to show you how screwed up this country is. And how screwed up that whole entertainment thing the Oscars are. She is known for giving a Hummer to the president.
Mm-hmm.
Period.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
And now she's accepted by Hollywood's elite.
Hollywood's royal family, yeah.
She is at these parties. Opie and I, we went to an Oscar party once.
Oh, we did, didn't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, remember? Remember 3 or 4 years ago? Remember that? A radio station in Boston was kind enough to send us out to Los Angeles for the Oscars.
Yeah.
We interviewed a bunch of hacks. We couldn't get near any of the stars.
Right.
So we figure, hey, there's the Oscar party at Spago.
Uh-huh.
We're going to Spago like everyone, like all the big Hollywood types, right?
Yeah, we figured we're in L.A. and we're on the radio. We're pretty important. We'll get into this party.
Spago! So we cart our asses down to Spago,
yeah.
where there's a line of geeks and freaks looking for celebrities. And we realize at this point, we ain't getting in.
Of course
not.
Wait.
But at least we found a 2x6 board
mm-hmm.
up on 2 cinder blocks.
Yeah.
That put us a little higher than the crowd so we could gawk with the rest of the freaks.
Well, you got to explain, too, that was kind of like the press area sort of, Ant.
Sort of. I didn't understand what it was.
There was some paparazzi up there and some reporters.
Mm-hmm.
So we're like, hey, we're on the radio. We got these groovy-looking badges that look
sure.
important.
Yeah.
We'll go into the press area as well. Maybe we'll get a couple questions out, you know?
Yeah. So we go from, you know, maybe having dinner with Madonna at Spago to, all right, we'll just stand on this board.
And just watch the celebrities come and go.
Gawk at people, sure.
Yeah.
We're up there no longer than, I guess, a minute. Some big guy comes over and goes, hey, you can't stand on that. We got kicked off of the board in front of Spago.
Yeah.
We couldn't even stand on a 2x6.
We weren't worthy enough to stand on a damn
no.
piece of wood.
But Madame Tonsil Hockey gets into all the parties with her big, fat, glittery dress.
Yeah.
And he stains on it that night, Monica? Did Jonathan leave a stain?
You know what is more disgusting than all that? Katie Lang is quoted in the paper today that she told Monica that she had a sex dream about her.
Sorry, Katie. There seems to be something missing on your anatomy that she really likes.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, where's that?
Monica was seated under table 14. That was, no, honestly, I'm not going to take credit for that. Don't worry, because I know people heard it somewhere else. That's Jay Leno's joke that he told 100 people.
Oh, really?
Every time you saw Jay Leno on TV, he was telling that same joke. He was so proud of it.
Well, Monica Lewinsky, she's seated under table 14.
Isn't that funny? Check, please.
What a buffoon.
Well, there you have it.
How about that Monica Lewinsky, people?
Yeah.
You know, she was seated under table 14.
What a mess.
What? What do you got, a little note? Phone call?
I don't know. Kevin, you got to, like, print, I think.
Yeah, what is he writing in cursive?
Yeah, it's
give
like...
Give me that. Let me see.
All right.
Come on, get out of here. He's writing
Kevin's like our intern. He's great. He's screening the calls. Now read what it says.
Wait. He scribbled out the first two.
Yeah.
And you can't tell what he scribbled to what he wants you to read.
Yeah.
Because it looks like the scribble. Fine in good... What? To speak to...
Oh, you have issues. You have some problems.
NEW, what do you have?
You should go over to MTV,
hey,
see if you could be a VJ.
Hey, it's Dennis.
Who is it?
My name's Dennis.
Hey, Dennis, what's up?
Just touching upon the Monica Lewinsky thing.
Yeah.
I was watching Good Morning America yesterday, and one of the ladies was there, and she said she couldn't even get to Monica. There was a huge line, and supposedly Monica's hanging out with Madonna.
Yeah, I'm not a huge Madonna fan. But all of a sudden, Madonna was, like, kind of tossed aside because Monica was there.
I think
Madonna has done more for our society than...
Not much.
Than Monica. But that's how we think of this country, you know?
Yep.
It's Monica. Everyone wanted to see Monica.
Yep.
And she's known for one thing. The presidential schween. She has embraced it, loved it,
yeah,
serviced it.
Yes.
And that's what's making her famous right now. They're taking pictures of her... And meanwhile, presidential penis is ready to launch missiles into Yugoslavia. This is great. Is anybody interested in that? Maybe we're going insane as a country. Maybe we're just insane now.
President getting ready to shoot his load once again.
His load of missiles.
Yeah, his military
of
load.
That's right.
I will take my missile and thrust it right into
Kosovo.
Kosovo, who's she? I like them foreign broads. When can I get some of that Kosovo? Yeah.
Well, you know, his wife and daughter are out of the country.
That's what I hear. Yes, Africa, is it?
They're taking a little 12-day trip of Africa.
They've been over there a lot.
Yeah.
There's so many countries to visit on the globe, and for some reason, they went a while back, and now they're going again.
Now, interestingly enough, I think we have exclusive audio, Anthony.
I don't doubt it.
Why
wouldn't we?
We got audio of Hillary and Chelsea in Africa.
I can't wait to hear it.
We'll be playing that a little later on in the show. Also, where's Black Earl?
Where is he?
Where's Earl? We got to talk to him today.
He's rejoicing that his pictures, the pictures of him getting disciplined by Spike, were kicked off the webpage.
Well, a lot of people sending instant feedback saying, hey, man, why aren't you telling your faithful listeners that you guys got censored again? We talked about it earlier in the show. We got censored by what, WebJump?
WebJump was WebDump to me and Opie. They took our pictures off.
Mm-hmm.
And we read down the list of reasons that you might get dumped off of WebJump. And the only one that fit was obscene material.
Yes.
They can judge what's obscene. The Supreme Court still has not decided what obscene is. Can't define it. But WebJump has realized maybe that Mentos video was obscene.
That was classic. I showed so many people that this weekend.
People like that one.
Big time. Well, we're going to find another server, I guess, because that's the sixth one we've been kicked off of.
Yeah, seven's a charm.
So don't worry. We'll get the pictures back eventually.
Oh, they'll be back
when we find a cool server. Now, where's Earl? Is he still in the building?
I think he's in the bath.
All right. Well, here's the deal. Because we're running so late, let's just play a few spots, and we'll come back hopefully with Earl.
Okay.
Instead of music. Is that cool?
That sounds good.
Can we handle that?
You're going to perpetuate these rumors, Opie.
What's that, Anthony?
By not playing music.
What? No one's talking about that.
I read something in the paper.
Huge article in the Daily News.
Yeah.
Rumor has it we're going all talk. We had the boss on earlier, and he didn't confirm or deny the rumor.
He's out right now looking to whack the staffers that spoke with the Daily News.
Yeah.
Our boss will do that. You'll find two people that worked here in the river, floating in the East River.
Well, we got a bunch of rats on the staff. We know that already. A bunch of rats going to the press, talking about our private meetings, staff meetings. That's just stupid. All right, it's Opie, it's Anthony, and it's our buddy, our pal, Earl. Black hey. Earl, everyone.
What's up, man?
What's happening?
Earl can't stay long. He's very busy. He's working very diligently today.
Well, everyone's getting ready for the Dave Matthews thing tomorrow.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We have tickets to give away? Yeah, we do. We forgot to give away our tickets last hour.
Oh, we can do that.
We'll do that. But, Earl, I notice you're still standing. You haven't sat down since Friday, or?
I'm in pretty good shape, actually.
Are you?
Yeah.
Were you sore at all this weekend from your beating from Spike?
A little sore in the groin area, but other than that, I'm fine.
She was stepping on him with high-heeled Spike heels.
Yeah. Are you sore from the high heels or from the what was that?
And I never used to like...
Well, don't get too happy.
Don't get yourself too attached to...
great.
The current format.
No, we're teasing, of course.
All I'm saying is, I like certain kinds of music.
This is the line you got to... This is what you got to listen to when you're, like, in a bar trying to pick up a chick. You got to listen to these stories. We're like the guy with the coke to the coke whore right now. Like, she'll say anything to us.
No, just listen.
What?
New York has, like, such an incredible music scene.
You know, in the bar, Opie, you got to sit and listen, like, yeah. And meanwhile, you're just going, God, I hope this pans out.
Yeah, because in your head, you're thinking, man, I wonder what you're
like. Yeah, yeah. So you act really interested. Yeah, the music scene in New York. Damn the music scene. Yes, it does suck. God, we are so much alike.
No.
You know, we are so much alike. I love puppies, too. I love puppies.
I love gay magic, and I don't care what you think. I love them. I love them. I travel thousands of miles in some of them.
Yes, we know. We know.
In London, in Amsterdam, and I've seen them here all over the country, and I want to see them tomorrow.
I put her on hold.
No, I agree. Yes, the tampon, much better than the pad. Am I getting laid tonight? Please, so I can finish this conversation.
She's probably freaked out because we put her on hold. We're on delay. Hold on. Hello? Hello?
Hi.
Hi, I thought we lost you there.
No, I'm listening to you. Put me on the radio.
Oh, my God. Oh, look at her. Now she's listening to herself.
Now she's back on hold.
Now, obviously, we didn't even ask her the question, but it's so obvious she's not going to get it.
Right.
But now she's a huge Dave Matthews fan.
Hi, who's this?
Hi, my name's Jim.
Hi, Jim. How are you?
Good, good. I'm calling. This lady's so annoying, man.
No, hey, really?
Can I ask you a question?
All right, look.
Isn't it? It's just like every girl you try to pick up in a bar.
Yeah, man, and you got to put up with it.
You got to, because you're trying, you're working it. Yeah. No, I do understand.
Yeah, it's
yes. No, tell me about how your father screwed you over again. God, I love that.
Yeah, I sympathize
so much. Oh, you poor thing. If I could work up a tear, I'm in.
And inside your head, you have this hourglass, you know. So
yeah, and it's going down like your schween.
Yeah. All right, so what's your deal with Dave Matthews?
Yeah, I think they're a great band. Fan of your show. And I'll take a stab at the Viagra question.
All right. We made an analogy about Viagra when it first hit in the summer.
Like acid?
No. That's a good one, though.
It was close.
Yeah. All right, man. Thanks.
Bye.
This is a hard one, man.
Hi, NEW.
Hi, I'm calling to win the Dave Matthews tickets.
All right, what's your name?
Michael.
Hi, Michael. Where are you calling from?
I'm in my car in the northern state. I just left Huntington.
How's the traffic?
It's not bad.
All right, cool. You got an answer to the ONA trivia question?
I didn't hear the actual. They were comparing Viagra to something?
Yeah, we did an analogy about Viagra when we first.
Oh, is this Opie?
Yeah.
Hey, I was at the Longshore Brewery a couple weeks ago.
Right on,
all
man.
Right, good time.
You got an answer, dude? Because your phone's crapping out on us.
Oh, you compared it to crack?
No.
Ah.
All right, man. Yeah. We got to go. Your phone sucks.
Okay, so
all right.
Thanks.
All right, here's the deal. Here's the deal.
Yeah.
We'll take two more callers.
Yeah.
If they know the answer, they get the tickets, flat out. If not, I'm going to give it to the huge Dave Matthews fan.
I figured you would do that.
Is that cool?
That sounds okay.
All right.
She's going to freak now if someone gets this.
Because he's still listening.
Yeah.
Hi, NEW. NEW.
Yeah.
All right, what's your name?
My name's Mike.
All right, Mike, do you know the answer to the ONA trivia question?
I do. Jesus.
Uh-oh.
I know, I was listening.
All right, we need an answer, dude.
All right.
Put the bong down.
Yeah.
It was, Viagra was compared to...
he's milking it.
I do now. I forgot.
I know. Sorry. All right, thanks.
All right.
It's compared to the thing that you guys once called a...
Oh, my God.
All right, what's your... All right, this is the last...
Hang up on them. They're such ding-dongs.
All right, what's your name again?
You didn't know my name in the first place.
Oh, yeah, what's your name?
Laura.
Laura the annoying caller.
I'm
Laura
annoying.
The annoying Dave Matthews caller.
You're going to regret that.
All right, Laura, here's the deal. I'm putting you on hold.
Okay.
If the next person doesn't know the answer, then you got the tickets for this private show.
Dude, leave her on the line.
All right. Yeah.
Let's let her live through this horror.
I'm suffering while I listen to the radio.
All right. Stay on the line. Hold
okay.
on.
Okay.
All right. God, I hope he gets it.
I gotta make this work.
I hope he gets it.
Laura? Laura?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Hold on.
I hope this works.
All right.
Ah, I hung up on her. Hold on. Wait.
Who's
Laura?
This? It's Laura.
All right, hold on.
Who's this?
It's Laura.
Hold on, everyone. Goddamn phone.
It's like mission control over there.
When we go...
Oh, we've lost Houston.
All right, when we go all talk, I hope they fix the phone. All right, Laura.
Yeah?
All right, hold on the line. I'm going to try this again. All right. All right, hi. Who's this?
This is Kyle.
All right, Kyle. Hold on.
What a pain in the ass.
All right, Laura.
Yeah.
Kyle.
Yes, sir.
All right, cool. All right, Laura, shut up, all right?
I'm not saying anything.
All right. I just wanted to say...
Shut up.
No, believe me, it was a preemptive shut up. We knew it was coming.
Preemptive
All right.
Go ahead.
Kyle, for the Dave Matthews... Where are you calling from, Kyle?
Manhattan.
All right. For the Dave Matthews...
Are you a big Opie and Anthony fan?
Huge. Guys are hilarious.
And how long have you been listening?
About 3-4 months.
This could be good then.
This could be good.
Could be good for the girl.
All right, Kyle, what is the answer to the ONA trivia question? We'll give it to you again. When Viagra hit the scene in the summer, we made an analogy of what it was like.
Ecstasy?
No.
Oh, man, come on, guys. I'm going all day.
Sorry, man. Can't take two
Hello?
People.
Laura.
Yeah?
You're going.
Yeah!
Look at her. Listen to her. She's squealing.
Yes. Oh, yes. Thank you.
To be honest, I wanted to give them to you from the beginning because you're too cool.
Oh, stop. What are you trying to pick her off?
Yeah, listen to her.
Is she hot? I gotta know.
Wow, she almost went from like being real excited about Dave Matthews to having like an orgasm.
I know.
Yeah.
Yesterday I was calling all of
you. No one wants to hear this.
I won't talk
because
you're going to just make fun of me anyhow. So
all right. What'd she say?
Now she's all...
Don't be pissed.
What, are we married?
I just don't want this whole thing to be on the radio. My friend's probably at work going, oh, my God, that's Laura.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, bless you. I'm so...
What's the station?
So
all right, listen, we got...
Yeah, we got to do the big contest outro.
We got to do the tagline, you know, when like Z100 and all those go, what's your favorite radio station?
I'm sorry, my heart's being so bad.
I listen,
so happy.
Laura,
what?
What's the radio station that wants to see your balloon knot?
WNEW?
Yeah.
Oh.
All right. How do we do this?
All right, hold on the line.
Okay.
Hopefully I won't hang up on you. And you got the text for Dave Matthews.
Thank you.
We'll see you tomorrow with Ralph Tatora, all right? All right. Laura's on line 5.
Wow.
That's cool.
I'm exhausted just listening to her.
Well, the Viagra analogy, it's good, but we got to take a break.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do it a little later. How's that?
Okay, we'll fill you in on that.
Yeah. You want to hear, Pearl Jam or AC/DC next?
It depends on the Pearl Jam. I've heard some, Pearl Jam is very iffy with me. Sometimes I love it, but there are some songs I cannot sit through.
Jeremy and Nothing Man.
Those are pretty good.
AC/DC, You Shook Me All Night Long or Money Talks?
I've heard those enough.
Really?
I've heard all four enough, to tell you the truth.
Well, when we go all talk, you won't have to worry about it.
Stop perpetuating rumors.
Well, everyone else is talking about it in the city. Let's make believe we don't know anything.
We're
about
not
it.
Supposed to talk about such things, I'll bite.
All right, Pearl Jam or AC/DC? You said Pearl Jam?
Go with the Pearl Jam.
All right, we'll be back. All right, we'll take a little musical break here. On the way next, some audio from Hillary and Chelsea's trip to Africa. It's an Opie and Anthony exclusive. In the meantime, it's 2 for Tuesday. The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday with Pearl Jam, Nothing Man, and Jeremy.
Just love hearing you say that.
What, 2 for Tuesday?
Twofer.
A twofer, everyone.
It's a twofer on this Tuesday, on this 2 for Tuesday.
Care!
Hey, stop it. You're not supposed to say things like that. Been yelled at. See, we're able to, with the twofers, get, you know, the second cut could be more of a tastier cut, Opie.
Mm-hmm.
Tasty twofer Tuesday cut for you. Tasty tune on a tasty twofer Tuesday.
When are we going to start doing Black Party weekends? That's what I want to know.
Hey, get the lead out. Let's get the lead out.
All right. You know, as a goof, when I was working in Buffalo Radio, you know, because every station was getting the lead out. That was the big thing. Let's play three in a row from Led Zeppelin called Get the Lead Out. It'll be Zanerific Radio. I started a thing in Buffalo called Mandatory Metallica.
Oh, Mandatory Metallica? That was you?
Yeah, that was me.
Ho ho, that's taken over the whole country.
Mm.
I've heard that.
That's the latest, so. All right. Well, we could play the audio from Chelsea and Hillary.
Mm-hmm.
Clinton, they're over there in Africa. We got some exclusive audio.
Okay.
Or we could go to the phones and talk to our drunk friend Jay.
Jay's on the phone, huh?
Well, you hung out with Jay this weekend, right?
I was up in Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, hung out with Jay, and it's always a common theme when we're hanging out.
It's very funny. We got to explain Jay. Anthony and I, very good friends off the air. This is not like a little, you know, goof we do, you know, where we act like we like each other on radio and then hate each other like every other team in New York. And we have one friend.
Yeah.
One friend. We've known each other for 5 years. We have one friend.
That's true.
And it's Drunken Jay.
Drunken Jay.
Drunken Jay.
He's not drunk now.
No, I'm not. Thank you.
Make him sound like he's drunk all the time.
Thanks a lot.
I know. Isn't that great?
It's so funny because, like, when I hang out with Jay...
Yeah.
We do, like, athletic stuff.
That's true. You do maybe some rollerblading.
Or, you know, we'll, walk the streets and check out record stores and stuff.
Right.
Right.
Now, when Anthony hangs out with Jay, it's just drinking and brunch and throwing darts at things you're not supposed to throw darts at.
Yeah, the liver has to really get in tune before... What we have.
We're still doing sporting events, but they take on a whole new, I don't know.
Now this is a theme that is running through because since we've been back in New York, I go up there to visit because my wife Jennifer's family still lives up there.
Mm-hmm.
So we go on little outings. The first one you may have remembered was the Renaissance Festival that I went on. Now, so it wouldn't just be me and Jen and my mother-in-law and maybe Annie Marg, who was at the original Renaissance, so the festival was a whole new thing to her. It was cold. She told us it was accurate.
Yeah, it was a revival for her.
Oh, King Richard, I did him. So we went to that. Well, we're drinking beer like crazy. We were just like big steins. We turned into those knights. Yeah. By the end of the day, we're tanked throwing hatchets at wood. It was supposed to be at the wood. But then we're just picking targets. Bet you can't hit that tree.
I stand about 6 feet tall. There was a tall girl right next to me, and I missed bad. I'm talking the hatchet just bounces off the wall. And this you know, teenager who just handed me four hatchets while I have to put down two beers to get them. Dude. Why don't you, like, move back a step or two? So now the hatchet is equal with her head, and I whip it, and it just goes right past her ear.
But, of course, he had a few, and she was laughing, too.
Everyone was laughing at the hatchets and the drunk people.
Now, you guys almost got kicked out of a bar Sunday?
Well, no, you got to remember now, there was another time we visited where me and Jen and Jay figured we'd go bowling. But we couldn't find, you can't find cool regular bowling up there. So we had to do that fag candle pin bowling.
Oh. With the tiny ball that looks like a softball.
The ball's like the size of a softball. The pins are little candlesticks, and you whip this ball down there. So, of course, drinking. And then at one point, Jay bet me that he could take this candle pin ball, throw it down, which is a regulation lane, alley, same length. Without hitting the lane, the ball will land in the center of the pins, thus scoring a strike. I couldn't get the money out of my pocket fast enough to see this. He shot puts this thing. He gave it a little too much. It hit the sign. You know those big signs over the alleys that say, like, you know, Junior League Bowling starts here? Yeah. He hit it, the letter, like alphabet soup. They're falling all over every other lane. We started unlacing our shoes at that point. We knew.
Were out of there quicker than a chippy at one of Fredo's get-togethers.
Godfather reference.
Godfather reference.
We love Godfather references. So now I'm up there this weekend. So we decide to catch some brunch. This is the Sunday tradition. We go to this small place that has a little brunch and drinks that are made like just don't smoke near them. So what were you drinking? You were drinking those vodka grapefruits.
They call it a grape greyhound.
A greyhound.
But it's basically a big thing of vodka with some yellow food coloring.
And I had some Bloody Marys and stuff. And then we decided we'd hit the bar down the road to play some darts.
Wait, can I explain the bar?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a bloodbath.
I've been there.
Yeah.
It's called Green Acres.
Yeah.
And this is a place that has all-out bar fights every weekend.
It's a small local place, but they need bouncers in the place because somebody will always be dragged out kicking, punching.
It looks like one of those old Burt Reynolds movies every Friday night and Saturday night.
Just insane.
And on Monday, they're replacing the panes of glass outside every single Monday. I'm not exaggerating. This place is just a sick bar.
Exactly.
People get kicked into this bar.
Now, so the story goes you guys went there Sunday.
Sunday after brunch.
You almost got kicked out of this bar.
No one
gets kicked out of this bar.
Well, we're playing darts, because that's what we went there for. Oh, and yes, two to drink. And the game of darts just didn't seem exciting enough, so we had to play it from the table we were sitting at across the room, which still wasn't bad because we were trying to hit the dartboard.
Yeah.
Then it got to the point where Jay starts taking the chalk that you score with and making X's on various things around the bar, and we're betting a buck a shot who can get closest to his X. So it's like the fire extinguisher, whap, whap. Fook, my buck, you know, you hit the guy coming out of the bathroom. That doesn't matter if he passed the extinguisher, it has to hit the extinguisher. It was a mess.
People were walking right by us. You're the one, though. Hey, try to hit the outlet.
Yeah, I wanted.
And you know what? I was so bad off, I just said, you know what? There's no way I'm going to hit it anyway, so I just threw it anyway. So.
Yeah.
And Jen was giving us looks like.
Oh, she was getting pissed. And then the owner of the place was like, you know, keep this up, you're going to have to leave.
We don't want your kind.
And, of course, I turned around and just said, told him.
Hey, Jay, St. Patty's Day wasn't the same this year without you.
Oh, no. Man, I'm sure.
We went to...
I'm sure there's a lot left over.
Well, it wasn't like last year with the kids blowing off the fireworks in the streets and stuff.
No, Sally in Boston, very Irish down there. And, they celebrate St. Patrick's Day different. I think they're training the children for the IRA. I swear to God, we were walking down the streets of Sally in Boston, St. Patrick's Day. Yeah. These kids, I don't know where they got these things. They were called bomb packs. I kid you not. It's a package that you pull this little string out of and then throw it, and 10 seconds later it blows up. It makes like a little, you know, little kitty explosion, but it in fact blows up.
Yeah.
And I hear some of the fathers going, "No, son, this is how you do it. First you got to put the hood of the car and put it in the carburetor. That'll get the British bastard. F the Queen." I was like, dude, you're in Massachusetts.
Oh, man.
Hey, we have some fun when alcohol's involved, don't we?
That was some fun.
Yeah. All right. All right, man. We'll be up there, soon.
All right.
See you again. Think up some other sport.
maybe we could do?
Well, we're trying to hire Drunken Jay for our show.
Maybe Crowded Street Javelin Throw. I like that.
Anything else to add, Jay? Or
No.
You don't want to abuse us back or anything?
All done?
No.
No. I'm too drunk to do it.
Still, of course, because it's our friend Drunk Jay.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, poor guy. Come on.
What a name.
It.
Guy's a well-respected man in the community.
In what community?
Well, the drunk community, but it is a community.
Yeah, I'm the town drunk. Let's pull that old one out.
Now, Otis, back in the sale.
Oh, no. I'm out of here.
All right, he's done. Take now he's mad. All right, we'll see you soon, man.
Bye, man.
Later. It's our pal.
Jay, our only pal.
Got to go two states away just to hang out and drink with somebody.
The Rock of New York, 1027 WNEW, 2 for Tuesday, AC/DC, Money Talks, and You Shook Me All Night Long. It's Opie, it's Anthony,
hey.
And it's Australian Mark in the studio.
G'day, how's it going?
Good day, eh?
I don't even know what that was.
man, I think we need to explain that. On the way, a chance to win Dave Matthews tickets. Mark just cursed.
I couldn't tell.
If he was on Australian,
it's an Aussie curse, it doesn't count.
Yeah, if he was on Australian radio, he wouldn't have gotten away with what he just said.
Exactly. Or would you?
Hey, I know you.
Are the rules strict down there?
No, they're not. No, there's no. It's a little more relaxed there.
Yeah.
Well, who cares if a kangaroo hears you?
Well, we invited Mark onto the show today.
Everyone always pictures kangaroos. That's all that's down there. Yeah.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Hey, how are the kangaroos?
Run to school on them every day. Yeah.
Every day.
Yeah.
Koalas, man.
Oh, yeah, the koalas, too.
Come on.
And that crazy guy that's on the Discovery Channel.
Here we go. I'm going into the hole now. I'm going to pull him out by his balls.
What's that crazy guy's name?
I'm going to stick my arm here in the crocodile's mouth.
The crocodile hunter,
pull his tonsils out.
I don't recommend you do this at home.
It's like, yeah, well, I'm going to go down the street and go catch the croc and roll him.
Well, we got Mark in the studio because...
anything's better than throwing another shrimp on the barbie, that's all.
Yeah, how many times do you have to hear that?
And have you ever had a Vegemite sandwich?
Love the stuff. You got to be winged on it, though.
What is Vegemite?
It's like a yeast, black soy sauce paste extract.
Ooh, stop. My mouth is watering.
Very salty, but, you know, you're raised on it, so...
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's an acquired taste.
Kind of like the next day after you eat White Castle.
Yeah, that's acquired. Now, you finished Half Life.
Yeah,
I did indeed. We were talking about this.
Yeah,
before.
We brought Mark in because, like myself, he's going through withdrawals because this weekend I finished Tomb Raider 3.
Yes.
Well, I started Christmas Day.
Mm-hmm.
So it was 3 months.
Mm-hmm. 3 months. Yes.
Which is about your time, right?
That's what I say. Yeah, it took me 3 months to finish Half-Life, yes.
And I had no life
for
that period of time.
So Half-Life is you spend half your life playing and the other half trying to catch up on sleep.
But life has returned. And
I feel empty. It took me 3 months or just under to finish Tomb Raider 3.
Right.
Yeah.
And this weekend I got a lot of stuff done. I'm like, wow, free time.
Yeah, time on your hands now, huh?
It is so bizarre. For the first time, I worked on our radio show in 3 months.
Yeah, I realized that when I was watching Ally McBeal last night.
Yeah. I'm like, damn, why am I doing this? It is so bizarre. It's like an addiction. It starts out, these video games or whatever, it just starts out as a stress relief. You know, a little bit of fun.
Recreation,
a little entertainment instead of watching the boob tube and stuff. By the end of the game, it's an addiction.
You have to finish.
It took the first couple of weeks, and it becomes an obsession.
Yeah.
You cross that line where you start dreaming about it.
Mm-hmm.
it's bad. Oh, it's bad.
How are you going to get through that next little course?
Right.
I turned you on to this, so... I felt like I was the drug dealer.
You were
bringing you on.
Come on, man, give me a hit. I need a clue, man. Come on.
Give me. I got to get through this part, man. The monster's around the corner, and I have no ammo.
Does the grenade go under the cab or under the tank or over the tank?
Yeah, which? How do I blow it up? Now, come on, that's up to you. I fronted you enough information. But I felt that way when I first went into Electronics Boutique to pick up a game. Mm-hmm. I walk in and I'm looking through the games, and the guy comes over and goes, "Hey, man, you looking for a game? Yeah, yeah. Check this out." Hands me the Half-Life box. He's going, "This is some good..." Like, yeah? Goes out, "It's the best in the place." Like, all right, thanks. I almost, like, put it under my jacket and snuck out. No, I paid for it. Yeah. Then I got home and my relationship paid for it. Because I was on there for 12 hours straight a lot of times. And when you finish, you feel like, oh, great, now what? You know?
That's a big letdown. It's like a drug because you lose all your relationships.
Yes, relationship definitely suffers.
Your work suffers.
Mm-hmm. No sleep.
No sleep. Just like good. Crack cocaine.
You are a crackhead.
Yeah.
With these games. I understand. I'm with you.
But now I got all this free time. I don't know what to do. I'm going to
get another one.
I'm going to have to get another fix.
It's a stepping stone. You need a bigger and better one. That's the problem with Half-Life because I can't find one that's really as good.
I met my wife last night.
Yeah. You're back with her, right? Okay.
She's looking good after this much time.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm thinking Siphon Filter for PlayStation.
That looks good for PlayStation
because I got the PlayStation.
We need Team Fortress 2 to come out. Half-Life Team Fortress 2.
We need it now, man.
Coming out now, man. I'm hurting real bad. Yo, Sierra, I'm hurting real bad. I need this. You don't understand, man. Look, I got a camera and a telescope. I'll sell it to you. I just need it.
You know, I must say, too, when I completed Tomb Raider 3, it was a big letdown. I was expecting some huge bells and whistles.
Fanfare.
I was expecting you finish the game and all of a sudden on the screen just goes... And there's like a number or something you have to call because you finish the game, right?
Yeah. And then what?
You can only get this number if you get to the end of the game. And you dial up the number and this hot blonde comes over and gives you oral favors for free for finishing the game.
Oh, come on.
Well, I was expecting more than a stupid helicopter comes down and takes her away and that's the end of the game.
Oh, is that what happened?
I thought it was going to open up the treasure, man.
Well, we got like the smoking man from Israel.
Yeah, throughout the whole game, you'll be playing, you're battling these huge beasts, and then you look up, you're dying, you're being shot, you're being blown up, you're trying to kill somebody. You glance up at a balcony, and there's a guy in a suit walking by looking at you.
Yeah.
And you take a few pot shots at him, doesn't hurt him.
Yeah.
So finally, at the end, you get to meet this guy, and he tells you what the whole thing was. Fills you in.
Right.
And then tells you want to keep working for him or you got a decision to make. You make the wrong decision, you end up back with a bunch of monsters.
Hmm.
You make the right one, you go on to the sequel, I guess. I don't know.
See, I was expecting like Lara Croft to come over and give me a personal lap dance for finishing this game.
I wouldn't want a lap dance from her. She'll shoot you.
Yeah, that's true. But it was a letdown. I was expecting something serious.
Well, you need your next fix.
Yeah.
A real empty feeling now.
Opie, the end of an addiction is never a happy moment. You need more.
More,
just means
more,
you need
more.
Yeah. You can't be satisfied. You're addicted.
Hi, NEW. We need video game rehab.
Hey, what's going on?
I don't have a problem. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I just need more games.
What's up, buddy?
What's going on? I got a suggestion. Oh, dude, I got a great Half-Life story, actually.
Okay. Uh-oh.
I finally beat the game.
You
about
did.
A month ago.
All right.
And after I beat
my
the
name
guy,
is,
it
and
ended
I
up
happen.
That my sound kicked out. So I couldn't hear what that dude with the glasses and the briefcase was saying.
Uh-oh.
So I just spent months playing this thing, and I couldn't figure out what the end was.
Oh, my God, it was the secret to life. Oh, you missed it. Oh, well, try again.
So I finally beat it the other day,
uh-huh.
And it was kind of like a letdown again.
Yeah, I know.
It was kind of like he was like... Would you like to
Gordon.
Join us, or would you like to, you know, fight the monsters again? So I joined them, and the screen went black.
Yeah, well, then it's for the sequel, I guess. I don't know.
All right.
What do you guys are going through withdrawal, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I got a good...
real bad.
I got a quick game that could be possibly help you. It's StarCraft.
StarCraft, I know. Yeah,
I'm not StarCraft.
Drunk Jay, our friend, plays that.
Yeah, I'm not into that one.
Not into the strategy games?
Well... I don't know. I'm looking at Siphon Filter for PlayStation, I think.
I like first-person perspective. Quake 2.
Looks good. It's like the methadone of
Yeah. Yeah, I know. It's like we need the methadone of video games right now. It's like Quake. Quake 2 is a methadone for me.
Right, yeah.
It's not quite filling me in, giving me the buzz that Half-Life did.
Mm-hmm.
But I need something. And then I have my Half-Life team fortress coming out.
Right.
And then Half-Life multiplayer that I'm on every night.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm getting along. I'm not feeling totally fulfilled, but, you know, it's working for now. One day at a time.
Oh, man.
It's hard.
It really is. I don't know what to do with myself tonight.
But yeah. Well, you'll figure out something.
I almost threw the PlayStation through the window.
You get those moments.
Well, like I said, it starts out as a fun game, and by the end, you want to kill somebody, literally. You're so pissed off.
I was never a computer game sort of guy before this.
Yeah. Right.
It just kills you. Yeah.
But
it takes all your time.
I was doing Tomb Raider 3, and I was going further and further into the game one day, right? And I was getting really far, and I'm like, should I save the game here? Don't have enough save crystal. Should I save? It was a big decision. I'm like, no, I'll go a little further. Went a little further. I'm like, should I save here? No, I'll go a little further. Keep going, right? Now I'm finally ready to save the game. The lights flicker in my house.
Oh, no.
And it goes off. And I'm like, this has got to be Canon camera. Where's the damn camera? I looked at the TV in shock as it pops back on where I was, you know, before I started the day's work.
And now Merv is on.
I almost threw the PlayStation through the living room window. I'm like, you've got to be kidding. You've got to be kidding me.
You'll get annoyed.
I had to start over at that point.
That's part of the anger and anxiety of an addiction, Opie.
Right.
When it doesn't go your way.
All right.
Now, did you cheat a little?
Yeah, of course I cheated. Cause
I think you always got to cheat a little.
Because I was talking to people about Tomb Raider and 3 and stuff. And, you know, I had my fun. I figured out a lot of the game on my own. But it got to the point, why did I have to play the game perfect so I could brag that I was, you know, I figured every single part of it by myself? Of course I cheated a little.
Yeah.
When I have fun, sure.
You know, jumped online and got some walkthroughs and stuff. Of course.
There you go.
All right. Well,
you got to hook up a multiplayer. We'll do some battle.
That's my little method.
Team Fortress. Yeah. Yeah.
So I can.
We'll get through, Max. We'll get through.
What is. Hi, NEW.
Hi, I was still on hold.
All right, what's up?
Not anymore.
Who is this?
Opie and Anthony.
Hello, how are you?
Good, how
are you? I can't believe I'm actually getting to speak to you.
Cool.
I've been calling for days, and every time I call, people slam the phone
down. Oh, no, really?
And they're rude to me, and they say they're busy, they have no time.
Well, what you have to say must be very important.
Well, no, it was just my feelings were hurt, and I couldn't understand.
Why were your feelings hurt?
Because nobody would talk to me, and every time I hear you guys on the radio, you're so nice to everybody's so nice.
Okay, now we're listening.
I've been calling for 4 days now to try to win tickets, and that's all I wanted to do, and I said, all right, I gave up on that. I just want to speak to them, tell them I love their show. I have a great time listening to them. I even sent you an email, and I couldn't get through, and the guy says, now they're busy. He slams the phone down on me, and I said,
wow.
Yeah.
That's kind of cruddy that they do that. So I was, you know, my feelings got hurt because I've been listening to NEW for like 25 years, and then when Scott, you know, I was getting kind of, you know, so I stopped.
Boy, anyone else see that coming?
It's waiting, my God.
Telegraph that one, huh? All right, well. To that lady, if she's still listening, there's a problem with our phones. Okay.
Thank you for that little AA meeting.
Right. Yeah.
I feel better.
You feel better now? Good.
All right.
We'll all get it. Well, we have to play this.
You want to play it now instead of taking a break?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hopefully there's people still listening.
We're talk station now, right?
Pretty much, according to the paper.
Just rumors.
People are quitting left and right around here today.
What's going on?
They're abandoning ship. Our buddy Ken Dashaw just quit, I heard.
Did he?
Oops.
Ixnay.
Sorry.
No one knows what we're saying. No one's listening.
Okay, listen. So Chelsea and Hillary are in Africa.
Yes.
They're away from the old man for 2 weeks.
As far away from Bill as possible. Mm-hmm. And it's so obvious things are going on because, like, he's in a crisis right now with Kosovo.
Yeah.
And she should be there.
Yeah, of course.
You know, supporting him in a decision that might cost men their lives.
Mm-hmm.
And she's out parading to Africa. You know, it's obvious that there's nothing there. Nothing.
Spending a couple weeks in Africa. We got exclusive audio, Anthony, of Hillary and Chelsea's trip to Africa.
All right.
Would you like to hear the first clip here?
I would love to.
Okay, let's take a listen.
Mom, are these people cannibals?
Now, Chelsea, why would you say that?
Because the chief said he'd give anything to eat me.
He sounds a lot like your father.
Your mother Hillary is very respected here. She has the one quality that is most coveted in our village.
What's that? Wisdom? Compassion?
No, a fat white ass.
Oh, well.
Your African name, Chelsea, is Kiala Abalafu.
That's beautiful. What does it mean?
Lanky pale girl with face of a wombat.
Oh. Hey, Mom, Mandingo wants me to go into the forest with him. I think he's going to let me have one of his pets.
Why do you think that, Chelsea?
Because he said he's going to give me his 12-inch Ubangi black snake. Oh, it's beautiful out here, Mandingo. By the way, what does your name mean?
It means man with three legs.
But you only have two legs.
Oh, really?
Wow!
Kelsey, when we are through tonight, the whole village will call you Iwachalakanaya.
Neat! What does it mean?
That means she who cannot sit for weeks.
Ooh!
Now grab your ankles, Chelsea, and I will demonstrate what your father does to your countrymen.
Wow! You gotta be kidding me. Who knew that was going on? They show those nice clips on the news of them smiling.
Well, I got part two of the bit. Would you like to hear it?
Yeah, we might as well be kicked out of the whole state.
Okay. All right, so continuing with the saga Hillary and Chelsea in Africa.
Okay.
Here we go. Let's listen to another
part
episode.
Part two?
Part two, yeah.
Oh, Mandingo! It's so big! I need two hands to hold it!
Oh, that's it, Chelsea. Now wrap your lips around it.
Like this?
Yes, that's it. Now blow, Chelsea. Blow.
Nothing's coming out.
Oh, be patient, Chelsea, and blow harder. Bullseye.
Thanks for showing me how to use your blowgun, Mandingo.
Anytime, Chelsea. We best go back to the village and find your mother.
I wonder where she is.
Maybe she's in this hut.
Oh. Mom, what are you doing with Mandingo's sister?
Oh, dear.
You said you were going on a safari.
No, no. I said before the day ends, I want to be deep in the bush.
Well, you do what you want. I'm going to help Mandingo take care of a bad animal.
What are you talking about, Chelsea?
He wants me to spank his monkey.
Well, just be back in time for dinner.
Okay. Well, what are we having?
I don't know about you, but I'll be having the African beaver.
Now, come on. That isn't real audio from their trip to Africa, is it?
I don't know.
Wow.
Our source is pretty reliable, Anthony.
That is just out of control.
Wow, the Hillary and Chelsea audio, big hit.
People seem to have liked that one.
Big, huge hit. AnthonyPriceline.com.
Ah, we love Priceline. You want to save some money?
Huh?
You going to be at a hotel anytime soon? You going to be out of town maybe or in town?
Mm-hmm.
You need a hotel room? You want to pay full price for that hotel room? Mm-hmm. No.
No way.
So what do? You call Priceline at 1-800-PRICELINE. Or you get on the web at Priceline.com. You name your price that you want to pay. You feel is a reasonable price for the hotel room. And Priceline gets you the price. You get the hotel room. Everyone's happy. You've saved money.
Yeah, these guys have been on our show for a while now. And I just don't understand if you're going away in the near future, need a hotel room or an airline ticket, why you wouldn't call to see what they could do for you.
It's free.
And the cool thing is, if you use their website, Priceline.com, you put down the price you want to pay for a hotel room. Within an hour, they're writing you back saying if your price was accepted or not.
Yeah.
And sometimes they'll bargain with you. They'll say, well, look, I can't give you a hotel room for a dollar, but I'll give it to you for $75. It's usually $150. Whatever. They'll make some deals with you and do the best they can.
Significant savings, yes. Not just like, hey, we'll save you a buck.
Right.
Like, hey, get out of here.
Yeah, why bother at that point?
Yeah.
1027 WNEW, the Rock of New York. Officially a threefer from the Doors, Anthony.
Ho ho. Officially. You caught us.
Blue Sunday, Peace Frog, and Backdoor Man.
Dude.
What?
Dow down 218.
Uh huh.
Closed down. Now, this amazes me about Wall Street, if I may quickly. See, it says mounting concerns that corporate earnings growth may have slowed substantially caused fear and selling on Wall Street. So, all right, that now it goes down. But then in 2 weeks, it's like the bright economic future caused a rally on Wall Street.
Yeah.
And then like 2 weeks later, you get, oh, it's looking grim again, folks.
We're all fickle.
Does it happen every 2 weeks? Like, can't you get a big picture on the economy, look at it and go, it's good, it will be good for a few months to come.
But there's a lot of people out there that day trade, and they ride the highs and the lows, and that's how they make their money, eh?
Yeah, but the market takes the big dumps and big gains on rumor, at least, or news of the economy,
right,
being good or bad or heading toward good or bad. So how could it change every other day? These people are like, oh, mounting concerns. Oh, low earnings. Oh, boy, it's looking grim. Inflation. Oh, boy, interest rate. And then 2 days later, it's the same things, but they're good.
Everything's rosy.
And that's why everything went up.
Now, how did Infinity Broadcasting do? Because there's a lot of rumors about NEW. Did that affect the stock price today, Anthony?
Last I checked, it was down. It was down.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
You think that's because of us?
I think it plummeted after the Hillary Chelsea Africa bit.
Man, that's a great bit. I want to hear that again already. Don't worry, knowing our show, we'll play another four times this week.
Oh, yeah. Like MTV over here.
All right, listen, we got to get a Dave Matthews ticket winner.
Yes.
Dave Matthews playing a special show for us tomorrow with Ralph DeTora at a secret location.
Mm-hmm.
God, I know the place, too. Oh, that would really piss off a lot of people, though.
No.
Uh-oh.
Why is the boss in here?
Hi, boss.
Oh, my God. Bye, people. Bye.
He doesn't have a baseball bat, so I think we're okay. He was on earlier. Mr. Herman, how are you?
Hey, guys.
We like to call him the big boss man.
Good.
Did you hear
him? He walks in. I get scared and stuff. Like, he's going to...
Why do you get scared?
You know? The Opie and Anthony program will no longer be heard in this time slot.
I am armed with cassettes and phone messages. What could I...
Oh, really? Cassettes of what? Our show? That people mail you and...
As a matter of fact, yes.
Point out little things that we've done and...
You got to talk into the mic. Yeah,
there we go.
Hi.
What's the latest complaint? We just got through a nasty complaint and we're safe, right?
I hope so.
We won't say which one.
Yes.
We made it through that one?
Mm-hmm.
Unscathed?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What's the latest one?
The latest one is we have to make sure that we're doing the Stacker commercials.
Yeah, right.
Okay? That we mention their slogan.
Yeah.
Which is the world's strongest fat burner.
Right.
And that we just treat the client very nicely.
Oh, yeah. We love Stacker.
We have been.
Opie's been taking Stacker, too. Look at him.
And it has helped me.
He's a lean, mean fighting machine.
That's the first thing that comes to mind when I think of it.
They don't like the drug references that we've made in the
past.
Okay.
Correct.
Oh, they were done in jest.
No. I know that. But, you know.
It's called kidding.
I know, but you know what? These people are buying time. I mean,
okay. All right.
The comedy portion is when people are not paying for it. Okay?
I say.
We have the comedy portion.
You pay for the comedy portion.
Exactly.
Okay. So what's the tape?
Yeah.
Is the tape
that looks like a tape of our show.
Saying something bad?
No. As a matter of fact, it's fine.
Oh, okay.
But, you know.
Did you hear our last bit?
There are times that I can't be at the radio, you know, and like I have things taped, and I listen to it when I go home so I could just...
Was the tape rolling on the Chelsea Hillary in Africa bit we just played?
No.
Oh, good. We didn't play it. We don't even have one.
You may be getting some calls on that tomorrow.
<Is that bad? laughs>
Well, no, it's that good.
It's that double entendre humor that you told us to work on.
It's a cute little bit. This guy, Mandingo, teaches her how to use a blowgun.
Maybe we want to move to triple entendre.
Triple entendre?
Quadruple entendre. That way no one understands.
Right. All right. So you didn't hear that bit. That's good.
All right. Good.
You'll have a happy drive home then. For once. Any other news there?
No.
Reporters calling about the story in the Daily News?
Yeah, they are. And you know what? Rumors are rumors. I mean, we talked about this earlier. Who starts rumors?
Other stations.
Exactly.
Other stations, boss. Other stations, right?
I mean, all radio stations are always looking for, you know, things they should be doing to get more listeners, to get more listening.
True.
You know?
Oh, okay.
I mean, but, you know, Jesus. I mean, I get nervous when I think, you know, the only thing you really know about the newspaper...
Yeah.
It's like your business.
Right.
And then when you know how poorly things are written about your business, doesn't it get you to worry about it?
I know.
It's like when you're reading about the war in Yugoslavia, when they could possibly be right about that.
I know. It's halfway around the world, and we don't know from a hole in the wall what the actual facts are. Yeah, when they write stuff about you, you're like, wait a minute.
That's not true. But no one's going to believe me.
Yeah.
So. But we're allowed to talk more, right?
Sure. Absolutely.
Yeah, talk more and play in that great rock. See?
We played six songs today.
The whole day?
Yeah.
So far, was it?
See, that's where rumors come from. That's how that crap gets in the paper.
Well, who wants to hear a Sticks twofer? Jesus, we got a Chelsea and Hillary bit to get
to. There you go again. Now the music department's going to get all upset.
I'll get him, boss. Opie, that's not productive. It does you or the station no good to downplay the music.
Right.
What you do is good, but the music also helps to... Could you shut me up? Could you throw something at my head?
Very good, Anthony. That would fall into the idle bitching category.
No, I think that's the fake remorse.
Can we play a couple on there, too. Can we play a couple songs that we dig tomorrow? Really dig? I want to play, like, Godsmack.
Godsmack's good. I want to play Rob Zombie. His new one, Living Dead Girl. God, that song rocks.
Would that make you happy?
Yeah. Tomorrow, can we play a couple of our faves just as a goof?
Sure.
Is Gary still gone?
Gary will be back tomorrow.
Oh, damn.
I want to play Whatever by Godsmack. My new favorite song.
Is like the language okay, or like, am I approving something that
we'll get the radio edit.
No, the Godsmack Whatever is one of the hottest songs in the country right now.
Okay.
You'll get the radio edit, though.
Hey, it's your show.
We could find that. And then Anthony wants to play a couple. And
Living Dead Girl, yeah.
Living Dead Girl would be cool. I mean, I like the Doors and stuff.
Okay, we've just gone from, can I play one, to, I want to play a few, and Anthony wants to play a couple.
Come on.
Next thing you know, we have anarchy and another article in the paper.